Welcome to another video of About Koi, and in this video we will look in detail to the Kikusui variety. In this video you will learn everything about this variety, what aspects you have to look for during the selection, and what the difference is between a Kohaku, or a Deutsche Kohaku, and a Kikusui. A Kikusui looks quite similar to a Deutsche Kohaku. And just like a Deutsche Kohaku, also the body of a Kikusui is white, with red markings on it, just like a normal Kohaku. But if you look closely, you can actually see that there is a difference, and that the pattern is not really red, like a Kohaku has, but is more like orange. And the contrast of the edges of the patterns, so the red patterns, are very, very sharp on Kikusui. And the reason for this is that a Kikusui is a Deutsche variety. So it doesn't have any scales, which makes the edges of the pattern really, really sharp. And that is actually something that can be really nice of this variety. So take into account that these three koi are really young at this moment, about 10 to 11 months old, from breeder Yamazaki. Well, the aspects that I'm going to share with you, you have to take into account for all Kikusui. Doesn't matter which breeder, it doesn't really matter which age. All the aspects are, well, for any Kikusui, relevant. And I mentioned before that Kikusui are quite similar to Kohaku. So the orange on these Kikusui is actually red on Kohaku or Deutsche Kohaku. So first, a bit of more details about what metallic is and why this variety is metallic. So what is typical for metallic is that you can see on some parts of the body, for example on the dorsal fin, that it looks very shiny. You can also see this in the pectoral fins. And if you look closely, you can also see that there are shiny lines visible that like follow each line of the fin. In Japan, we call this pika. A pika will really look good in your pound when the sun is shining. So it gives this variety really something extra, is what I believe personally. So this variety, the Kikusui, is bred by combining Kohaku together with Platinum Ogon. So the red or orange is from the Kohaku. And the Platinum Ogon is actually a white metallic fish. So you can imagine that the shiny parts of this variety, like in the fins, in the pectoral fins, is from the Platinum Ogon. I want to start with the white body. If you select the Kikusui, you want to make sure that the white areas are really, really white. And if you look at this head, then you can see that there is actually some gray, kind of gray looking area in the middle of its head. It happens a lot more on Kikusui, and honestly, you prefer that area is really, really white. There shouldn't be any gray, there shouldn't be any black. All areas should be really white. So if you also look at the sides of a koi, make sure that all sides are as wide as possible. A good indicator for white is actually also the tail area. If the tail area is white, good white color, like here, that is usually an indicator that all part of the body will be, well, nicely white. So, and then when we talk about the red or orange pattern, I'm going to say orange from now because Kikusui are really, really orange. You actually have to consider all the same aspects as for a Kohaku or a Deutsche Kohaku. And that is about mainly about the pattern. So for example, for a Kohaku pattern, you don't want that the red or orange, the orange for Kikusui in this case, is laying over the eye. So for example, this eye, it has one good blue eye, the other eye has some red on it, and the red is laying like on the eye, the orange is laying on the eye. That is something that we don't prefer. So same as this Kohaku, the red is a little bit over the eye. Well, preferable the red lays in between the eyes. And another aspect that you also take into account for Kohaku, so also the same for Kikusui, is that the nose should be white. So preferable like this Kohaku, well, there is orange on the head, but preferable around the head, and the nose should be white. So the in between the eyes should be orange, The eyes should be clean, so no orange or red in the eyes, preferable. You don't want the orange area to be too large, so honestly this orange head is a little bit too large. It should be a little bit smaller. You want some white on it visible. So this Kikisui has a little bit better head pattern. The preferable also the nose should be white in this case. And it would be okay if the orange was a little bit more towards the nose area as well. But it's not a bad head pattern. And I mentioned that a Kikisui is actually a metallic variety. And you can see that on some parts of the body. For example, on the dorsal fin, also on the pectoral fins. And in Japan, we call this pika. So on each, in the pectoral fin, you can see the lines. Like in between each ray of the pectoral fin, you can see a shiny line. That is called the pika. And pika really looks good when, for example, the sun is shining on the fins, on the pectoral fin, on the pectoral fin, on the dorsal fin, on the tail area. You can see that it, like, yeah, it's a lot of luster, it shines in your pound, and that is really, really something nice that gives something extra. A key aspect for Kikisui is that it has good and intensive pika visible in the fins. So, for example, this Kikisui really has good pika. It's really bright, the pectoral fins are both really bright, the dorsal fin is really bright, even the tail has really good pika. So you want good pika to be visible in the pectoral fins, in all fins actually. And when we talk about the pattern, so the orange markings, we prefer to see a multiple step pattern. So here you can see that this Kikisui has one step here, and then near the tail, one extra orange step. Well, that of course is a little bit of personal taste. And what also look or can look really good is a really playful pattern on a Kikisui. For example, this one, if you look at the main, well, the body section, it's a really rounded, playful pattern. And that is something, yeah, typical for Kikisui, typical also a little bit for Deutsche Kohaku. But you see it a lot on Kikisui that it has like small balls, small round areas of orange visible. Also really playful on this one that it has the orange like right next to the eyes. Quite unique as well that it is symmetrical, I would say. So makes it quite a unique Kikisui. Also for Kikisui, you don't want that within an orange area that there is a gap visible. And a gap is if, for example, in this area would be one round in the middle that is white. That is something that is not preferred at all. I can demonstrate it because all of these three Kikisui do not have a gap like what I'm explaining. But you want to make sure that no white is visible within an orange pattern. Then about the tail section, preferable is also that Kikisui have an odome. And an odome is like this koi has, that the last part of the tail is actually white. So if we take this Kikisui, this one, you can see that actually the tail is all orange. And well, it's not so preferred. Sometimes it can look quite okay, but the idea is that an odome makes a koi look larger in the end and look bigger, so the body posture will be better when it becomes larger. Well, it would be a little bit better if the orange in this area was a little bit longer, or that there was some small orange dot still visible just before the ending, like in this area. But it's, yeah, it has a good odome, so that's quite good. When it is larger, it is acceptable to have an odome of about 1 to 2 centimeters of white visible. And I mentioned before about pika in the fins, actually in all fins. You also don't want any red to be visible on the pectoral fins. On the dorsal fin, you don't want red in the tail. You don't want any red in, or you don't want any orange in any of the fins. And of course, just like with any variety, so also for Kikisui, you should take body aspects into account. Because even if you have a perfect pattern, really, really good pattern, still if the body is not that good, then it will never become a really, really nice koi. And I'm not going into full details in this video, but I'm sure if you watch more of my videos, you will know already by now which aspects I look for when I select a koi regarding the body. Well, and some of the basics are that you, of course, want a good backbone visible, because the backbone, when a koi grows, it explains how much mass can be gained when the koi is growing. You want a high tail section instead of only a broad tail section, but of course also a broad tail. You want a torpedo looking body. You want the eyes to be widely placed. You want a long head preferable. Well, that is some of the basics that you should take into account for sure. So far about the Kikisui variety and which aspects you have to look for when selecting them. Hopefully this video was useful for you, and by now you know some of the basics to look for when you select a Kikisui. And if you like this video, please consider to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we will update regularly new videos about anything related to koi, like koi guides like this one, and koi selection guides, or anything else that is related to the topic of koi. Thank you for watching again, and see you in the next video.